What will your husband say is the most ridiculous thing you've ever seen him imitate? And be very specific, because he's going to have to do that imitation.
Funny, really, I do.
It's not.
You can always expect the unexpected on the Newlywed Game. In color, it's the Newlywed Game. Now let's meet our newlywed couples for tonight. Couple number one. She proposed to him on a ski lift. He said, okay, if you don't push me off. Married just 14 weeks ago, Henry and Darlene Kane Jr. Couple number two, after an argument, this newlywed husband once followed his wife into a ladies' room to apologize. Married just 12 weeks ago, Gary and Phyllis Dilger. Couple number three, these newlyweds say their honeymoon hotel room had no phone and no heat, but it did have a shower, a salt water shower. Married just 19 weeks, Chuck and Barbara Riley. Couple number four, he proposed for a year and a half before she said yes. Then they spent an hour and a half calling everyone they knew to tell them about it. Married just 12 weeks ago, Jerry and Shirley Dockel. Those are our newlyweds for tonight. Here's your host, star of the Newlywed Game, Bob Eubank.
Thank you very much and welcome to the Newlywed Game. You know, there are those who try to forecast the outcome of sporting events and those who try to forecast the weather. But our newlyweds may be involved in the toughest forecast of all. And that's trying to figure out what each other will say. Now, you'll see what I mean right after this message.
The Newlywed Game is brought to you by Raleigh, the filter cigarette with a taste that's easy to light. And coupons good for free gifts. Now, here's Bob Eubanks and the Newlywed Game.
Gentlemen, here we go, the Newlywed Game. As you know, your wives have been secluded off stage in a soundproof room. Gentlemen, what will your wife say was probably her body temperature the last time you gave her your most amorous kiss? What was her body temperature, Jerry?
Wow.
The last time you gave her your most amorous kiss.
Oh, I say 50.
50 degrees.
50 degrees.
All right. Chuck?
I'll hope it went up. I'll say 100.
100 degrees. Gary?
I'll say 100, too.
100. All right, Henry?
150.
Okay, next question, gentlemen. What will your wife say is the last thing she did that made you think she might have been dropped on her head as a baby? Last thing she did, Chuck. Something that Barbara did that might make you think she'd been dropped on her head as a baby.
Well, I have a pair of blue pants that I was going to wear to a party, and I told her not to wash them with anything that gets lint on them. And she somehow missed them, I guess, because she put them in with towels, gold towels, and they came out looking like they were spotted. So
I see. So you have blue and gold pants now?
I do.
Fine. Gary?
Will you repeat that again?
Please? Surely. What will your wife say is the last thing she did that made you think she might have been dropped on her head as a baby?
She was fixing this chicken one night, you know, and she likes the skin off, you know, and I like it on, you know, and she's got to skin hers off and mine on, you know, and she dropped, and she was real easy, just pan like this going like, and she puts it down. There's no tray, there's no thing to put it on, it just fell to the ground. No, you know, no table to put it on, you know, just fell down the ground.
Set it down in air, then, right? Henry.
Wearing square-heeled shoes.
Oh, you don't like square-heeled shoes?
No, the heel's round. It looks real funny with square. Heel round, square-toed, you know.
Yeah. Jerry?
The only thing I can think of right now is that she leaves the vacuum, every time she vacuumed the floor, she leaves the vacuum cleaner right in the middle of the floor.
She leaves the vacuum cleaner right in the middle of the floor.
Right in the middle of the floor.
Fine. Here's the last of our five-point questions. Gentlemen, when your wife gets out of the shower, will she say she usually starts drying off from the top down or the bottom up?
Gary, from the top.
She starts driving off from the top.
Top. Down, to the
right?
Down, right.
Okay, Henry?
She just kind of starts in the middle and just...
Yeah. Henry, you can't do that to me. I have to have one of the two. The top
right,
down or the
top down?
From the top down,
okay.
All right. Jerry?
I'm going to have to say from the bottom up.
From the bottom up.
Right.
All right. Chuck?
She usually just wraps a towel around her, but I guess from the top down.
From the top down. Gentlemen, thank you very much for your answers. And we'll be right back to reunite the newlyweds, and we'll see how well the husbands have predicted what their wives will say in just a moment.
Jane, I need more nails. Jane?
Here you are.
Oh, it's you, huh?
See, you're adding a roof.
Hey, you got a cigarette?
Yeah, sure.
Switched to Raleigh's filters, eh?
Decided you wanted to taste the cigarette.
Well, good taste is what a cigarette's all about, isn't it? So I'm smoking Raleigh.
Those coupons are a good idea, too. Now I got most of my tools.
Come to Raleigh Filters. Come to good taste. And remember, the famous Raleigh coupon also comes on light menthol Bel Air.
Bel Air tastes right, cause the menthol's right. Bel Air tastes right, cause the menthol's right. Just the right touch of menthol with a white filter too.
You get a special kind of lightness when you smoke Bel Air. Special because the menthol's right.
Okay, gentlemen, we've recorded your predictions on cards and now have them in your lap. Girls, what was probably your exact body temperature the last time your husband gave you his most amorous kiss? What was your body temperature, Darlene?
Oh, my goodness gracious.
Now, this is his most amorous kiss.
Oh, about 195 degrees.
195? Oh, Henry said it was 150 degrees. Does he kiss that amorously?
Not really.
Well, Henry, do you? Henry's taking notes.
I do.
Phyllis?
That must have been yesterday. It was 150.
115?
150.
Oh, 150. Gary said it was 100 degrees.
Oh, it probably was that
better
much.
Better than that.
Must be about 200.
Barbara?
Well, 4 degrees of temperature is kind of a lot. I'd say 100.
100 degrees. She said 100. That's right. You get 500. Now, Shirley, this was the last time that Jerry gave you his most amorous kiss. What was your exact body temperature?
Well, I was mad at him, so it was below average. Even though it was amorous, I'd say 96 degrees.
96. He said your temperature was 50 degrees.
Well,
that's the way you act all the time.
He was 50. Going in the right direction.
The way you act all the time.
Here's the next question for 5 points. Girls, what is the last thing you did, meaning you personally, girls, that made your husband think you might have been dropped on your head as a baby? The last thing you did, Phyllis, that might cause Gary to think that.
The last thing.
Quickly.
Well, I was acting like a big baby today because my hair didn't go right, and so I was running around the house throwing things and stuff.
Oh, you're running around throwing things and all right. Gary predicted the last thing you did.
You're
was
right. I didn't think
you
so.
Dropped a chicken in midair.
I forgot about that.
What chicken?
Oh, the chicken that took the other time. I guess it wasn't the last thing you did. But, you know, when you fixed when we had somebody over.
I was very nice that night.
Before they came, you did real well when you came. You know, first time I guessed.
What do you think, Gary? You want me to move on?
Yeah, you better go ahead.
Okay. Barbara? Last thing you did.
Well, the other night I did a little imitation of Mitzi Gaynor, and I'm corny as Candace and Augustine.
Oh, you did an imitation of Mitzi Gaynor?
Yeah, with all the kicks.
All right.
And
yes. Chuck said you got lint on his blue pants.
I did that, too.
Yeah. Shirley?
Well, it probably would have been the other night. We have a refrigerator freezer that we just got recently, And I got mad, and I wanted to break something or do something. And I went out and pulled the whole 500 ice cubes out of the refrigerator and threw them all over the floor.
Were you mad at him?
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. You threw 500 ice cubes on the floor. Jerry predicted that, no, you left the vacuum cleaner
all
the
time in the middle of the floor. Remember the cord runs from the bathroom out there and I started then?
Yeah.
Yeah, and
what
I
happened,
fell.
Jerry?
Fall.
They're going to think we live in a pig pen.
Well, you all time leaving it out there. Anybody comes in the house, they have to follow the vacuum cleaner. Buy a brand spanking new one. She had an old one. And boy, she'd rather have she'd put it away. She won't do that new one.
No.
No. Boy. She was right the other night.
Yeah.
She didn't mind.
Darlene? Henry, you all right?
Oh. Thank you.
Sorry.
Well, I can imagine it was last evening. He was taking his...
Well, last evening what?
He was taking supposedly a bath, but it ended up being a shower. And in the meantime, I just washed my hair and had it all fixed up nicely.
He's watching his right now.
And the nut took the bath water and the shower and everything and just turned it all outside, and there it was swimming in the hall, and I'm getting wet, and I zoomed by the air conditioner and I scratched myself on my hip. That's the last thing.
Oh, so you scratched yourself in the air conditioner, and that made him think you've been dropping your head.
Yeah, he asked you what was the matter with me.
Oh, Henry predicted you would say, no, if you wore a square heel shoe.
What's the matter with that? That's fashionable.
She has on the hair just like him. Just like him. Navy blue pattern, same color. What's crazy, Tom? Oh.
Here's the last of our five-point questions. Girls, as long as we're on the subject, when you get out of the shower, do you usually start drying off from the bottom up or the top down? Barbara?
Definitely the top down.
The top down. He said the top down, too. That's right. Okay. Shirley?
From the top down.
Top down. He says you dry off from...
Boy,
the
you don't need it.
You don't need it.
Why, I'm down here, not down there. Look at all my arms hurt.
You dry your feet off.
I do not. They're mad. Where were you when they're watching me take a bath or dry?
You never close the door. Then they're drying your feet off, and then you go up and do like that.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you do too. You never close
when
the door.
When you came in, I was all finished then.
No.
I was down on my feet.
Walked in a long time.
From the top down still.
There's still no points, though.
I know.
Darlene?
From the top down.
Top down. He said from the top down. That's right. You get 5 points. Phyllis?
The top down.
Top down. He said the top down. Right. 5.2. All right, couples. Thank you very much for your answers. Our 10-point question is next, and we'll be right back with just the wives to see how well they predict what their husbands will say on the Newlywed Game right after these words from Johnny Jacobs about gifts for tonight's Newlywed guests.
Thank you, Bob. And for tonight's Newlywed Wives, it's Mirror Go Lightly. Open the beautiful cosmetic case and out swings a fabulous mirror with expert lighting. It flips easily from regular to magnifying mirror, an elegant gift for home or travel. Each of the husbands will enjoy having a handsome portable tape recorder powered by the long-lasting Duracell battery from the Mallory Battery Company, the long-distance power cell that lasts far longer than ordinary batteries. Tonight's second-place winning couple will receive a complete 10-piece Bell & Howell Super 8 home movie outfit. Everything you'll need to take and show great movies, including a precision-built Bell & Howell Super 8 camera with zoom lens and automatic exposure control, and a Bell & Howell Super 8 projector that actually threads itself. And for each of tonight's couples, here's the Newlywed Game, second edition for them to play at home. Now back to Bob Eubanks and those amazing Newlyweds.
Hi, John. Thank you very much. Now, girls, your husbands have been secluded off stage, and now it's your turn to predict how they will answer these 10-point questions. So here we go with question number one. Girls, what will your husband say is his least favorite television show? His least favorite, Phyllis.
Oh,
Smothers Brothers.
Smothers Brothers. All right, Darlene?
Definitely Peyton Place.
Peyton
Place. Every time it comes on, he turns it. He says, I'm going to work. I said, but this is Monday night. You're off. I'm still going to work.
Oh. Okay, Shirley?
I think I'll go along with her, Peyton Place.
Peyton Place.
Yeah, all I used to like to watch it all the time, and he'd turn it off.
Okay, Barbara?
Well, I turned on Gomer Pyle the other night, and he had a fit. Hates Gomer Pyle.
Gomer Pyle. Next question, girls. Everyone has his own personal secret. Now, what will your husband say is his? His own personal secret, Darlene. What will Henry say is
his? His own personal secret. I'll tell you, he's got a hairpiece. To know about it. Well, I thought we were getting engaged once, and he says, I got a great surprise for you. We're going out to dinner. So here he is, zooms in, ta-da, and he's got on his hairpiece. And all I could do is look at him, honestly. I didn't get engaged for 3 months later, but still, you know, he had a hairpiece.
Where does he keep it?
It's in the closet.
Oh, okay. Shirley?
His own personal secret.
Everyone has his own personal secret. Now, what will your husband say is his?
And it must be a good one, because I can't think of any secret that he's got that I don't know.
I need an answer quickly now. Don't let that bell ring.
I can't think of anything.
Can't think of any answer at all. He doesn't have a personal secret. All right, Barbara?
Well, I can't really think of anything that's completely personal. But Chuck has gotten a paunch on him. And he doesn't think that it shows when he has his clothes on. But it does. But he thinks that, you know, with his... gets those new suits with the high side vents,
yes,
and they're all
right.
Tailored in and everything.
And his stomach does show.
And he holds it in whenever he's trying on clothes.
All right. Phyllis?
Well, Gary loves my toes, and he doesn't think anybody else knows. He kisses them, and I tell people, and he won't admit it in front of others. He kisses them, and he calls them his little twins, and when I tell other people, he denies it. He does.
All right, here's a 25-point bonus question. Girls, since you've been married, what will your husband say is the worst main course you've ever served him for dinner since you've been married? Shirley?
The other night, we were in a hurry, and I gave him canned spaghetti.
Canned spaghetti, fine. Barbara?
Well, about a week ago, I have a terrible time remembering to unthaw things. And when I finally remembered to unthaw him, he doesn't want that for dinner.
So what was it?
And I never know. Well, I took out a steak. It was a ranch steak, and I was going to pass it off as top sirloin.
Oh, it was a ranch steak.
Really bad.
Okay, fine. Phyllis?
Beef stroganoff.
Beef stroganoff.
Mm-hmm.
Darlene?
Well, I'll tell you, I'm a pretty good cook, but he's a better cook than I am. Can't recall offhand, so I'll just take a tacos I fixed him once.
Tacos. Time. Ladies, thank you very much for your answers. We'll be back with the husbands to compare answers on the Newlywed Game in just a moment. But first, this message.
Welcome to the invisible world of odors and germs. You can't see odors, but you can eliminate them with Lysol brand spray disinfectant. It clears the air, has a fresh, clean scent, but never leaves a telltale odor of its own. Spray it on surfaces to kill germs you can't see, the kind that cause athlete's foot, mold, and mildew. You'll never see all the reasons for using Lysol spray, but you'll breathe easier for it.
For headache pain, could anyone improve on Bayer aspirin, make it faster or stronger? Let's see. There's no sense looking for a stronger ingredient because aspirin is the strongest pain reliever you can buy. Combining other drugs wouldn't help, nor would buffering add speed or strength or gentleness. No one has ever improved on Bayer aspirin. Bayer is 100% aspirin, and aspirin is the strongest pain reliever you can buy.
Gentlemen, for 10 points, what is your least favorite television show? Chuck?
It's got to be Gomer Pyle.
Gomer Pyle. Gomer Pyle, right, for 10 points. Okay. Couple number four, Jerry?
Wow. Steve Allen show.
Steve Allen. I surely predicted you would say it's Peyton Place.
Peyton Place? I never even look at that thing.
But you don't like it.
Never heard of it.
When we first got married, I used to watch it all the time.
I did not. Never had watched it.
I did.
I don't know about you, but I never did.
Peyton Place.
Henry?
Peyton Place.
Peyton Place. Yes. Your wife said it was Peyton Place. Yes. Right. Yes. Of course. Yes. Gary? Well, she watches this show, and I watch it too, you know, and I always say, well, let's watch something else. At the same time, I'm going to watch this other channel. But I still like it, but she probably says it's my wife. I think it's a mother-in-law.
Mother-in-law's, all right. Phyllis Pretty would say it's a Smothers Brothers.
I like the Smothers Brothers. Every time we watch it together.
You do not.
Kiki Smothers helps
you're never
place.
Home.
Well, does that mean I don't like it?
You don't.
Because I'm not home? Remember, I always tell Murray was on that Kennedy thing, and I saw it, and I said, oh, there's Kiki Smothers. We like him.
Here's the last of our 10-point questions. Gentlemen, everyone has his own personal secret. Now, what's yours, Jerry?
The only thing I can think of, I got a lot of military stuff I keep in my house. And it's in a little bag, and I keep it in the closet. That's
all right.
I can think of that now.
Shirley predicted that that you don't have a secret at all.
Well, I didn't, but I didn't know you could say that.
Don't now either. Okay, Henry, your own personal secret. What's yours?
I'd say I don't have a secret either. She knows all about it.
Now, you have to have an answer now.
It wouldn't be a secret if she knew it, would it? It can't be like that.
Everyone has his own personal secret. What's yours?
Would I like to be a psychologist, maybe?
That you'd like to be a psychologist? Darlene told us that you have a hairpiece. Hairpiece.
Think of, like, you know, she always says, well, I stand too much and comb my hair.
You comb your hair too much.
Yeah.
Phyllis says, your personal secret is you kiss her toes and call them your little twins.
Much of a secret, but it's something she knows I'm not particularly partial to her disclosing. I use her hairspray probably as much as she
you
does.
You use her hairspray, all right. Barbara predicted that your secret is you have a paunch and everybody can see it. Couples, thank you very much for your answers. We'll be right back with a big 25-point bonus question to see which couple will win their grand prize tonight in just a moment. First, this brief message.
Just get me those figures.
Uh-oh, here comes acid indigestion. Excess acid starts dripping into your stomach. You need new Triactin, the antacid with a special stomach-relaxing ingredient. Triactin not only neutralizes acid, Triactin's special ingredient goes further to help turn off the excess acid faucet. Excess acid's gone, indigestion's gone. New Triactin helps turn off the excess acid faucet, liquid and tablets.
Only a few days old, and just look at her go. Meanwhile, down in the basement.
Honey? Hey, we can't use this carriage for the new baby. It's stupid.
Oh, yes, you can. When you clean and disinfect with new fantastic disinfectant spray cleaner from Texide. It cleans and disinfects with no foaming, no rinsing. New Fantastic makes light work of any cleaning job, anywhere in your home. Try our new baby. You'll like it.
All right, gentlemen, here it is, a big 25-point bonus question. For 25 points, gentlemen, since you've been married, what is the worst main course your wife has ever served you for dinner since you've been married? First of all, couple number four, Jerry and Shirley, was 0, 25. I'll give you 25, put you in the lead. Jerry, what was that course?
The worst one that I can think of offhand is she throws some spaghetti, bowl of spaghetti in front of me.
Spaghetti, all right. She predicted it would be spaghetti. That's right. 5 points. Okay.
$25. $25 would give you $30. Get it right, you'll be in the lead. If you miss it, you end up in last place. Gary?
Well, she cooked this chicken, and she over it. It was kind of hard, you know, and she's not...
So is your answer chicken?
Chicken, right.
Chicken, fine. Phyllis predicted you would say it was beef stroganoff.
We lost.
It's all right.
Couple number one, Henry. I would give you a right, Henry.
Excellent.
What was the score?
This thing.
You would say it was a steak. The surprise just true. A handsome, sort of beautiful, best creature, King
carvings and stones of this design and instruction can be endurable. And with certain piece of provision and cabinetry, King Size for those who are young with makers of time transporter and foam. Also available in spring, the Christmas that you were just born. And it's yours as winners of the game.
For people who like to watch television with the windows locked and the door chained, Journey to the Unknown is a compendium of terror. Discomforting tales designed to summon that consuming fear that drives the mind to distortion. Unknown in color on ABC.